Welcome back to another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos about WordPress for non-techies. And I'm going to share some resources for you in order to get excellent images for your website. Now, whenever you build a website, what really makes it stand out and look good is quality images. You have to have a resource for quality images. Now, there's several ways to get images. There's free ways, and there's dangerous ways, and there's paid ways, and I'm going to go over all those in this video. So first of all, here's the most dangerous way to get images for your website, and that's just to do a Google image search. So I usually do this in a safe way. Whenever I want a logo for a company, I'll do that, but there are certain image owners that will sue you to oblivion if you use their images. And a good example of that is Getty. Getty owns images, and they own a lot of images. And if they find you using an image on your website, good luck for you, because you are going to get a big fat bill that you're going to have to pay, or you're going to have to find some legal means to fight. And I don't want that for you. So this is the way Google Images works. So if I just type man and I do that, and then I click on images right here, it's going to show me a bunch of pictures of men that you might want for your website, or women, or something like that, or a scenery, or anything along those lines. This is Google Images. Sometimes it's okay to use. Like I said, I use it if I want to find a logo for a company that I might be doing something for. This is the way I do it. But you really have to be, it's dangerous. You're really playing with fire. And if you're building websites for your clients, the last thing you want is to take one of these images that someone owns, put it on your client's website, and then they get sued. It happens, folks. Now, there are several free resources that are actually fantastic. Here's one of them right here. It's pexels.com. I've used this many times, and when you scroll down, you can see the quality of the photos here. Now, the way they get their images, there's contributors that upload their images to this site, and you don't have to give any attribution or anything like that. And typically, the images that you find on Pexels are very high quality. Now, I think the way they make money is on some of the images, maybe all of them. So say if I clicked on this and I wanted to download it, you've got an advertisement here. And then right here, it says sponsored photos. And this is going to be photos that are on paid sites like Shutterstock, which is very expensive. These images are very expensive, but here, this one's going to be free, and there are similar photos. So I can see how they make money, right? You're looking for the perfect photo, you don't see one that's free, and then you come over here and you see one that's paid, and then maybe you just come out of pocket for that image. I love Pexels. I've used it a lot, and one of the bigger or larger free image websites is Pixabay. I tend to not like their images. Some people really do. I really don't. But you can come here to Pexels, and some of the images are going to be the same. You're going to find the same images on both sites. And with these, I think some of them you might need to give an attribution. You're going to see when you click into an image right here on the right. So if it says free for commercial use and no attribution required, those are the kind of images I like to go for. I don't want to have an image where in order to legally use it on my website, I have to give a link to some website or some place or something like that. I usually avoid those types of images. And then there's this new way of finding images, and it's called LibreStock. And there's, I think, another like this. And what this does is it kind of searches all of the free image websites and pulls all the results in one place. So if I was to type cute puppies, how about that? Cute puppies like this. And it starts showing me 135 results for cute puppies. These images are going to be in lots of different free image websites. So you might want to just come here instead of going to see, here's one from Pixabay. Instead of just going directly to those websites, you could just come here. It's like Google for these free image sites. And when you click on one of them, it's going to take you over. I think this site is ad supported as well. So right here, this is going to take me to Pixabay. So when I click on it, it actually takes me back to Pixabay where I could go ahead and download that image. So this is actually a good option as well. Now there's also paid options, and here's one that I've used and I've liked a lot. However, they recently increased the cost of the service, so I don't necessarily know if you would need it, but it's called Stock Unlimited. And this is a website where you just pay a fee and you can download as many images as you want, and you can use them in any way that you want. And they have some really high quality images here. Now, they recently increased the cost. They used to give you a lifetime membership for $89. Now it's more expensive. And they also added audio and things like that. They have an audio plan. They're not showing it right here, but they do have an audio plan. But right here is, you see, it's $139 for 3 years, which is a little pricing. That's, oh, and here's the audio plan, sorry, where you can get access to their audio. And it says free account. I've never tried their free account. You can also try that. So anyways, these are just some things that you could do to get quality images for your website. I'm going to add links to all of these sites that I've talked about down below in the pinned comment section of this video. Feel free to go down there and check out any of these websites. And if there are any websites that I have not mentioned that are really high quality, feel free to leave links to those down below in the comment section as well. Because you made it to the end of the video, I have a free gift for you. But before I talk about that, I want to ask you to do something for me. If you could give this video a thumbs up down below, that would really help me out. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and become a subscriber and support this channel. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you when I upload new videos, there's a little bell next to that subscribe button. You can click on that and set that up as well. If you have any questions or a comment about this video, I'd love to answer it. There's a comment section down below. All you have to do is put in your question or comment. I respond to every single one. Hey, I made a course just for you, and it's called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success, and I want to give this to you. If you'd like to enroll in this course, there's a button right here off to the right. You can go ahead and click on that, enroll as a student, and that's just my way of saying thank you for supporting me and making it to the end of this video. I make them just for you.